Here are the highlights of the two afternoon games of the 1961 IHSAA State Final Basketball Tournament. Hi, everybody. This is Dick Higgs speaking to you now from the Butler Fieldhouse. And we're just seconds away from this, the first game of the 1961 IHSAA State Finals between the Manuel Redskins and the Tell City Marksmen. Manuel of Indianapolis, under Coach Dick Cummings, comes into this afternoon game sporting a 27-2 record, while the marksman of Tell City, coached by Orlando Gunner Wyman, has 21-7 defeats. Now, quickly, here are the starting lineups. First of all, for the Manuel Redskins, it'll be Tom and Dick Van Arsdales at the forwards, Lurie Short at center, and at the guards will be Armin Cobb and Jim Cummings. For the Tell City marksman, it'll be John Arnold and Bob Kester at the forwards, Tom Crone at center, with Jim Meek and Dave Looking at the guard positions. And this ball game will get underway in just a few seconds. Well, here we are, all set to go in the first game this afternoon, the IHSAA State Finals between Tell City. Manuel, the tip is taken by Manuel, picked up by Jim Cummings in the backcourt. Cummings over to Cobb, and back to Cummings. Cummings dropped it, finally picks it up, goes out of bounds. Given to Tell City. Tell City now on the attack. Looking has it. Off on the side to Tom Crone. Back to Looking. As they work the ball around, no score. Ball game just getting underway. A shot by Tom underneath by Kester was no good. They fight for it. Manuel controls. Manuel has the ball. Into the offensive court it goes. Long shot by Dick Van Arsdale. Short. And Tell City clears the boards. A long pass underneath now. Back to free throw lane it goes. Off to Looking, his shot, no good. Manuel has it. Lurie Short, chest passing it. Out to Jim Cummings. On the far side to Cobb. Underneath it goes to Tom Van Arsdale. The basket, let's check it. A charging foul on Tom Van Arsdale. Charging foul on Tom Van Arsdale. At the free throw lane. Bob Kester, the basket counted by Van Arsdale. His free throw was no good, but Tell City controls. Down on the side it goes to Tom Crone. Off on the far side to Meek. Back to Crone. He'll shoot. He hits. Tom Crone scoring, and it's all tied. Manuel 2, Tell City 2, with 6 minutes, 28 seconds remaining in the first period. Off on the far side it goes to Armin Cobb. Manuel. Hit by Meek. It goes out of bounds. Awarded to Tell City. Meek throws inbounds to Looking. Off to Crone. Crone holds the ball, flips it back to the center lane. Off on the far side to Meek. To Crone. To Meek. He'll shoot 20 feet out, short this time. Manuel clears. Cummings has it for the Redskins. Manuel 2, Tell City 2. Off to Tom Van Arsdale. Pulled out from the post. Off to Lurie Short. He'll try one. No good this time. Underneath a tip by Tom Van Arsdale, and it's picked up by Tell City. Long court pass intended for Dave Looking goes out of bounds, awarded to Manuel. The score, Manuel 2, Tell City 2. As Manuel has it now on the offensive court, still going, stops back to free throw lane to Dick Van Arsdale, to Armin Cobb, to Cummings. Cummings still has it. Looks at open hands. To Lurie Short, back to Cummings. Cummings controlling the score, Tell City 2, Manuel 2. A shot, attempted shot by Dick Van Arsdale, is stolen by Tell City, and a foul's been called on Dick Van Arsdale. It's Crone on the free throw. The shot is good, and it's Tell City 3, Manuel 2, with 5 minutes, 11 seconds remaining in the first period. Manuel has it now in the offensive court. Off to Tom Van Arsdale, to Lurie Short. Back to Jim Cummings, back at the keyhole. Throw up to Cobb, his shot, no good. Follow up by Cummings. Bounces high off the rim, but pick it up by and finally cleared by Dick Van Arsdale. Dick Van Arsdale scoring on a twisting jump shot, and it sends Manuel into a 4-3 lead as Tell City has the ball now in the offensive court. They're going toward the north basket. Manuel 4, Tell City 3. Off it goes on the far side. A shot by Looking is good. 45 seconds remaining in the first quarter. A shot by Tell City was good. And now it's all tied. Tell City 13, Manuel 13, with exactly 36 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Manuel has the ball, almost dropped in there by Jim Cummings, but saved by Cobb. Hit knocked out of his hand, but picked up. Saved by Manuel. Cummings cuts to the deep corner. Finds that open man. It's Tom Van Arsdale. His shot. Underneath there's a foul. A foul on John Arnold. John Arnold of Tell City committing the free throw, or actually the foul, rather. At the free throw lane is Tom Van Arsdale. One shot coming. 13-13, all tied with 19 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Here's the shot by Tom Van Arsdale, and it's good. And it's Manuel 14, Tell City 13. Tell City very slowly in the backcourt, bringing that ball very slowly into the offensive court with only 10 seconds remaining in the first quarter. And this is the first game of the state finals. The shot by Crone, short this time, and it's picked up by Tam Van Arsdale. Tom Van Arsdale's long shot was no good, and that's the end of the first quarter. It's Manuel 14, Tell City 13. Picking up the action now here in the second quarter with a minute 27 seconds to go. A shot by Tell City was no good. A follow-up by Crone is good. Crone's follow-up shot was good for Tell City. And now it's Manuel 27, Tell City 23. Manuel by 4 points. Manuel has the ball in the offensive court. Underneath it goes to short. His follow-away jump shot was no good, but picked up underneath by Tom Van Arsdale. Goes out of bounds, but is awarded to Manuel. Cummings throws inbounds, off to short, he'll shoot, no good. And Tell City clears, 27-23. Manuel leading over Tell City. Off it goes to Crone, there's that shot, good. And it's Manuel 27, Tell City 25, as Tell City, with 35 seconds remaining in the second quarter, is trying to clear the, close the gap. Underneath it goes, a shot by Tom Van Arsdale was good. And he was fouled. Tom Van Arsdale. Correction. He was called for charging. The basket counts by Tom Van Arsdale, but he was called for charging. And the score now, with 31 seconds remaining in the second quarter, is Manuel 29, Tell City 25. And stepping up to the free throw lane for Tell City is Bob Kessner, 6'1", 160 pounds, a senior. Bob Kessner at the free throw line. He has one shot coming. It's up, and it's good. 29-26, Manuel by three. The Manuel Redskins leading by 3 points. Fling it down into the offensive court. And it goes to Tom Van Arsdale. He'll try a jump shot. Short. Picked up by Tell City. John Arnold has it. Off to Meek. And Tell City slows things down. They're working for that last shot. 29-26. Manuel leading, but by 3 points with 8 seconds to go. Crone has it. He'll try one. Short this time. Hits goes out of bounds, awarded to Tell City with 1 second to go. There's the end of the first half. And the score at halftime is Manuel 29, Tell City 26. Here at halftime, it's Manuel 29, Tell City 26. Manuel by a 3-point margin. And across the way, the cheerleaders of the Manuel Redskins are hooping it up. And in just a few minutes, the second half will get underway. And this is the first game of the 1961 IHSAA State Finals. Manuel and Tell City. And here at halftime, Manuel leading by 3 points, 29-26. Here's the start of the second half between Manuel and Tell City. Manuel leading 29-26. The officials in the first game, Jack Small and Paul Grimes. All right, action's ready to start in the second half. The tip is taken by Manuel. Picked up by Dick Van Arsdale to Cobb. To Van Arsdale, steps on the baselines, goes out of bounds. Awarded to Tell City. And the marksmen of Tell City bring it now past that dividing line slowly. They're behind 3 points, 29 to 26. A shot underneath, corrected by John Arnold, but a shot off to the side by Kester is good. A shot by Kester is good. It's 29-28. Manuel by one. Into the offensive court come the Manuel Redskins. Underneath to Tom Van Arsdale. His shot good. Tom Van Arsdale scoring for Manuel. And it's Manuel 31, Tell City 28, with 7 minutes, 16 seconds remaining in the third period. And it goes to John Arnold, back to Crone. To Meek, but he's called for steps. Awarded to Manuel. Cobb bringing it into the offensive court. And it goes to Tom Van Arsdale. He can't get a shot. He feeds it to Larry Short. His shot was no good. A tip up underneath by Dick Van Arsdale is good. Dick Van Arsdale scoring for the Manuel Redskins. And it's Manuel 33, Tell City 28. Now, Manuel leading by 3 points. Cobb has it in the offensive court. Off it goes to Dick Van Arsdale. Back to Cobb. He goes underneath. His shot no good. Picked up by Larry Short. He's tied up. Picking up the action now in the third quarter. It's all tied. 33-33. Manuel's call for steps, and Tell City will take it out of bounds. Tell City now on the attack. Off the far side it goes to Cron. Holds it high above his head. Flips it off on the far side to Kester. Back to Cron. To Kester. 33-33. A shot by Meek. Good. Jim Meek scoring from the diagonal. 35-33. Tell City takes the lead for the first time with 5 minutes remaining in the third period. Cummings. Correction. Cobb drives underneath and he's fouled by Dave Luking. Picking up the action in the third quarter with 3 minutes, 18 seconds to go. A free throw by Short was no good for Manuel, and Tell City controls 39-37. Manuel leading by 2 points as the marksman driving toward the south basket. Off on the far side is Crone. And a foul has been called on Tom Van Arsdale for shoving. Tom Van Arsdale, 6'4", 200-pound senior for Manuel, is called for shoving and stepping to the free throw line for the Tell City marksman is Tom Crone, 6'4". Correction. It is Bob Kestner. The shot by Kestner is no good. Crone picks it up. His shot was no good. And finally, Manuel controls. Tom Van Arsdale has it. Brings it in the offensive court. And he's called for steps. With only 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter, it's all tied. Manuel 39, Tell City 39. Manuel now on the attack. Shot by Cummings. No good underneath. And Tell City clears. Crone has it. For the Tell City marksman. The score, Tell City 39, Manuel 39. A pass intended for Arnold gets away and picked up by Manuel. Scheib, who's entered the ball game for the Manuel Redskins, in place of Armin Cobb. At Scheib now with the ball, you see driving toward the left forward position. Underneath it goes to Dick Van Arsdale. His shot is good. Dick Van Arsdale scoring. 40 seconds remaining in the third period. Underneath it goes to Short. His layup shot is no good. And he was fouled in the act of shooting by number 35, Bob Kestner. Bob Kestner of Tell City committed the free throw, or committed the foul, rather. And stepping to the charity lane is Larry Short, 6'3", 190-pound senior for the Manuel Redskins. Manuel leading 43-39 over Tell City with 38 seconds remaining in the third period. Here's the free throw by Larry Short. Up, his first one was no good. Larry Short will get another chance at the free throw lane. Manuel leading 43-39 over the Tell City marksman, coached by Gunnar Wyman. Here's the second shot by Short, and it's good. Manuel 44, Tell City 39. 3 minutes, 28 seconds remaining in the final period, the first game between Manuel and Tell City. Manuel leading 58-47. Manuel has the ball out of bounds. It goes from Dave Scheib into Dick Van Arsdale. Off on the far side to Jim Cummings. That's Cummings holding the ball. And it goes to Tom Van Arsdale. Off goes to Cummings. There's that jump shot. No good this time. And Tell City clears. Arnold got the rebound for Tell City. Off it goes to Crum. Underneath, a shot by Looking is good. Dave Looking scoring for Tell City, and it's 58-49. And time has been called by Manuel with a score of Manuel 58, Tell City 49. Time back in. Manuel has the ball. Dick Van Arsdale, long court pass to Dave Scheib. Underneath it goes to Cummings. His shot, no good. And a foul's been committed on Bob Kestner of Tell City. Stepping to the free throw lane will be Larry Short of Manuel. The score 58-49, Manuel leading over Tell City. Here's the free shot by Short. The first one is good. Manuel now by 10 points, 59-49. Manuel holding a 10-point margin. 2 minutes, 42 seconds remaining in the ball game. Here's the second free shot by Short. It was no good. Picked up underneath by Van Arsdale, tipped in. The basket was not allowed, however. It goes out of bounds to Tell City. All right, the marksmen have it, and to the offensive court they go. Off to Crone, 30 feet out. He can't get his shot. To Meek. Off to Looking. And back to Dave Meek. He falls to the floor, but picked up underneath by Arnold. His shot was missed, and finally cleared by Tom Van Arsdale, Manuel. But stolen from him by Dave Looking. So Tell City's on the attack. Here's Crone. His shot, no good. Underneath, basket is no good. It's cleared by Dick Van Arsdale, Manuel, and he's fouled by Tom Crone. Here's the free throw by Dick Van Arsdale. Manuel holding a 10-point lead, 59-49. Dick Van Arsdale's free throw, it's good. It's the 1-1 now with 2 minutes, 6 seconds remaining in this, the first ball game. And Manuel has increased its margin now to 11 points. Bob Sprinkle is coming into the ball game now for Tell City, replacing Bob Kestner for the Tell City marksman. All right, it's Dick Van Arsdale. He'll have another free throw coming. 60-49, Manuel leading. Free throw by Dick Van Arsdale. It's good, and it's 61-49 with Manuel over Tell City. With 1 minute remaining in the first ball game, it's Manuel 66, Tell City 55, as Manuel has the ball on the attack. A shot by Short, and he's fouled underneath the north basket by John Arnold, the center of Tell City. And it's 66-55, Manuel by 11 points with 54 seconds remaining in the first ball game. And Lurie Short has two free throws. Lurie Short, 6'3", 190 pounds, a senior for Coach Dick Cummins. The first shot by Short is good, 67-55. Officials in the first game, Jack Small and Paul Grimes. Here's the second shot by Lurie Short. He drops it through, and it's 68-55. Manuel over Tell City. Jim Meek at the free throw lane for Tell City. Manuel 70, Tell City 55. The free throw by Meek was no good, and underneath, Manuel controls. A host of substitutions now for both teams, but Manuel has it at the offensive court. And Leon Carter's call for steps, and Tell City takes it out of bounds. Tell City still controlling. A shot by Ahrens was no good, and Manuel controls. Rex Hedegaard has it. Off to Larry Short in the offensive court. Bounce knocked out of his hand, picked up by Tell City. Off it goes to Kress. Goes out of bounds. Let's see who it's awarded to. Awarded to Tell City. A long shot by Jim Meek was no good. They say, let's take it out of bounds again. So Tell City will feed inbounds. They do so. A shot by Owen is no good. A shot by Short was no good, of course. And the final score was 70-55. Manuel 70, Tell City 55. This is Dick Higgs speaking to you once again from the huge Butler Fieldhouse, and we're all set to bring you the second game of the 1961 IHSAA State Finals between the Kokomo Wildcats and the Logansport Berries. Kokomo, coached by Joe Platt, has a record of 26 wins and one defeat, and Logansport has won 24 games and dropped three. Logansport, coached by Jim Jones. Now, here are the starting lineups for this afternoon's second game. First of all, for the Logansport Berries, it's Fiddler and Gerald Fiddler and Ron McPatridge at forwards. Dick Shook at center, with Dick Modricker and Dan Farrell at the guard positions. For the Kokomo Wildcats of Joe Platt, it's Ronald Hughes and Richard Scott at the forwards. James Ligon at center and David Cox and John Pryor rounding out the guard positions. And we're just seconds away now from the tip-off of this, the second game. Well, we're all set to bring you the second game this afternoon between Kokomo and Logansport. The officials, James Boswell and Jerry Steiner, the tip is taken by Kokomo. Kokomo has it in the offensive court. A shot by Ronnie Hughes is no good, but cleared by Kokomo, and their call for steps. Logansport takes it out of bounds. Danny Farrell in the offensive court. Farrell still controlling, drives around deep in the corner, gets away from his man, tries a shot, and it's no good, but picked up by Logansport to Farrell. He drops it, and Kokomo has it. Ronald Hughes has it, and he's fouled by Dan Farrell. Ronald Hughes recovered the ball for Kokomo, and he was fouled by Dan Farrell. So stepping up to the free throw lane is number 11, Ronald Hughes, 6'1", 180 pounds, a senior. Free throw by Hughes is good. It's Kokomo 1, Logansport nothing. Logansport now in the backcourt. Farrell has it, off to Modricker. Modricker cruising past that dividing line, off on the side to McFatridge. McFatridge drives around his man, up with a shot, and he's fouled by Scott of Kokomo. Picking up the action now with 5 minutes, 44 seconds remaining in the first quarter. A shot by Logansport was tried, finally recovered off on the far side by Ron McFatridge. Hit by Scott of Kokomo, goes out of bounds. It'll be awarded to Logansport. Logansport feeding inbounds, does so way on the backcourt. A shot by Dick Modricker, and he is fouled by John Pryor of Kokomo. The score, Kokomo 6, Logansport 3, with 5 minutes 26 seconds remaining in the first period. Stepping at the free throw line is Dick Modricker. His first free throw was no good. Dick Modricker, 5'11", 154, a senior for Jim Jones of Logansport. His second free throw is good, and it's Kokomo 6, Logansport 4. Picking up action once again with 3 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Kokomo leads Logansport 10-6. Kokomo has the ball in their offensive court, off on the far side. Now it goes to Ronnie Hughes. He'll try one. It's no good this time. Picked up by Logansport. Logansport has it. Dick Modricker crosses that dividing line, off on the far side to Ron McFatridge. Can't find that open man. Finally spots Dan Farrell. He'll try one 30 feet out short. And Kokomo clears in the person of Richard Scott. Long pass, breaking pass down to Ligon. Goes out of bounds. And it's awarded to Logansport. It's Kokomo 10, Logansport 6, with 2 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Dan Farrell has it for the Logansport Berries. Off to Charles Fiddler. His shot was no good. Picked up underneath by Ligon of Kokomo. Cox for Kokomo. Off to Richard Scott. Scott drives down. Whistle. A foul called on Scott of Kokomo. During the end of the first quarter, it's Kokomo 19, Logansport 8. A shot by Ligon was good. And it's 21-8, and Kokomo has really shot into an opening lead here in the first quarter against Logansport. Underneath it goes to McFatridge, and he's tied up. Dick Shook, tied up underneath by Ligon. The respective centers for Kokomo and Logansport. Tip is taken, tapped way back to Logansport. A shot by Charles Fiddler was good. 21-10, that's the end of the first quarter. Kokomo leading. Picking up the action now with 5 minutes 50 seconds remaining in the second period. A foul has been called on Dave Cox of Kokomo, and stepping to the free throw lane for Logansport will be Dan Farrell. His free throw, first one, is good, and it's 23-11, Kokomo over Logansport. Danny Farrell's second free throw is also good, 23-12, and the Wildcats will take it out from out of bounds. David Cox brings it up. Off to John Pryor, back to Cox, underneath to Ligon. His shot, no good. A tip by Ligon is no good. And finally cleared by Farrell of Logansport. Logansport clearing, bringing it into the offensive court. Still going. 23-12. Kokomo over Logansport. 5 minutes, 30 seconds remaining. A jump shot by Farrell. In and out this time. They fight for it. A tip by Shook was no good. Finally picked up by Farrell of Logansport. Up with a shot. Blocked beautifully by Lincoln. It goes out of bounds. Give it to Logansport. He'll take it out. Logansport throwing inbounds underneath to Shook. Gets around Lincoln. A shot good by Dick Shook of Logansport. And it's now Kokomo 23, Logansport 14. 5 minutes, 4 seconds remaining in the second period. All right, the Wildcats are on the attack. Dave Cox, long, long shot. Good by Cox. 30 feet on the diagonal. Kokomo 25, Logansport 14. Only 52 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Kokomo 38, Logansport 22. Kokomo leading by 16 points. A foul on Dick Shook of Logansport. And the Berries of Logansport have called this timeout with 52 seconds remaining in the second period. James Lincoln up there. His first free throw is good. He's on the 1-1. And now it's Kokomo, 39, Logansport 22 with 52 seconds remaining in the second period. James Lincoln, 6'6", 170-pound junior for Coach Joe Platt's Kokomo Wildcats has the second free throw. It's good also. And now the score is 22-40, an 18-point lead for Kokomo. Logansport has it now in the offensive court, bringing it up. Still going, Danny Farrell has it. He'll try one, 30 feet out. It's no good. They fight for it underneath. It's picked up by Ronnie Hughes on a fast break. He goes, a shot intended for Hughes, finally tipped up and in by Hughes. Shooting that first was Glover. He missed, but Hughes was there to tip it in. And it's Kokomo 42, Logansport 22, and a foul out by the post position on Kokomo. All right, shot by Pereira was no good. They fight for it underneath, and they're tied up. Lincoln of Kokomo is tied up underneath the north basket with Vance of Logansport. It's 42-22, Kokomo leading over Logansport with 12 seconds remaining. The tip is taken by Kokomo off on the far side, a shot by Dave Cox is no good. Finally picked up by Foster. And finally Logansport controls. A long break down to Newton. There's the end of the first half. And the score at halftime, Kokomo 42, Logansport 22. Well, we're all set for action here in the second half. The tip is taken by Kokomo, but picked up by Logansport. And a foul has been called on the Kokomo team. And stepping to the free throw lane to shoot the free throw will be Charles Fiddler of Logansport. Kokomo leading by 20 points. The free throw by Fiddler was no good. And Pryor of Kokomo controls off to Hughes underneath the Lincoln, lays it up and in. James Lincoln got around his man and laid it up and in. 44-22, Kokomo over Logansport. Kokomo controls. Gets under, lays it up, and it's good. Dave Cox scoring for Kokomo, and it's Kokomo 57, Logansport 36, as the Berries have it now in the offensive court. Off it goes to Danny Farrell, cuts through the keyhole position, drops it, picks up by Foster of Kokomo, drives down, tries a one-hander, short, and Dan Farrell is there to control for Logansport. On a fast break, Farrell still going, starts to pass to McPatridge, puts on a play, a foul called on Kokomo. Only 36 seconds remaining in the third period. Logansport steals the ball from Kokomo. Off underneath it goes to Shook, and he lays it in for Logansport. 63-42, Kokomo leading. Kokomo has the ball in the offensive court. Bushlog has it. Off on the far side to Foster, to Bushlog. As Kokomo is taking plenty of time now, working their better shots. Shot by Cox, a short. Logansport controls. Danny Farrell has it for Logansport. A long, long shot by Farrell was no good. Underneath, he lays it up and in. Farrell missed his long shot, followed through and dropped it in. And it's 63-44. Kokomo leads at the end of the third period. Picking up the action now in the last quarter, 65-48. Kokomo leads. Logansport has the ball. Newton tries a one-hander, no good. Picked up by Kokomo. Dave Cox on a fast break, still going, drives to the keyhole, lays it up, no good, a foul, and he's called for steps, out of bounds. And Logansport will take it out of bounds. Newton inbounds to Farrell. Farrell crossed that dividing line, tries a 30-footer, short. They fight for it underneath, and Lincoln controls for Kokomo, cleans the boards nicely. off to the far side. They go to Buschlag, to Dave Cox, into Ligon in the post. He's tied up. It's stolen from him by Newton of Logansport. Logansport on a fast break. Newton lays it up. His shot no good. A follow-up shot was good by Ron McFatridge. And it's 65-50. Kokomo by 15 points with 6 minutes remaining in this, the fourth quarter. Kokomo controlling to Dave Cox. To Buschlag, to Ligon, to Cox, off in the corner. It goes to Richard Scott, 65-50. Kokomo leading, 15 points over Logansport. And it goes to Ronnie Hughes. He gets around his man. He tries one. It's good. Ronnie Hughes on a beautiful one-hander. 67-50, Kokomo leads over Logansport. 3 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter, and Kokomo is enjoying a 23-point lead at this time, but Logansport now has the ball. Here's Farrell shooting, 20 feet out, good. Dan Farrell zeroed in for Logansport, 75-54, 3 minutes, 26 seconds to go. Ronnie Hughes finally has it in the backcourt, passes off to Pryor, underneath it goes to Richard Scott. His turnaround jump shot, it was good. The basket, let's see if it counts. The basket counts by Richard Scott. Time has been called now by Logansport. Kokomo leading 77-54. Richard Scott now at the free throw line for Kokomo. There's the free throw. It's no good. Ligon tips a back door to Richard Scott. He gets around his man. He tries a jump shot. Good by Richard Scott. And Kokomo now leads 79-54. Logansport now crosses that dividing line into the offensive court they go. Newton has it. He cuts to the right. Stops. He'll try one. A one-hander almost banked it in, but cleared by Scott of Kokomo. On a fast break, it goes to Buschlag. His shot blocked beautifully, goes out of bounds, and is awarded to Kokomo underneath the south basket. Kokomo leading 79-54. Foster throws inbounds now to Isert, off to Buschlag. Kaligan can't get that shot away. Kokomo shooting in the person of Buschlag, and it's good. 81-54. Kokomo over Logansport. All right, Dan Farrell cuts through, whistle on the play, and a foul called on Kokomo. Vance shooting the free throw for Logansport. The first is good. It's 81 now to 55, with 2 minutes, 33 seconds remaining, and this is the fourth period. All right, Vance has another free throw. It's no good this time, and Kokomo clears. James Burke taps off on the far side. Off it goes to Buschlag, cuts back the free throw line. Buschlag still controlling. Off to Isert, to Buschlag. Isert and Buschlag, the guards, almost stolen from him by Kokomo, and finally is. And his steps are called on Newton. Newton of Logansport stole the ball, but he's called for steps. Kokomo will feed inbounds. Buschlag in the backcourt finally gets it up to Burt, and he's fouled by Logansport. Here's the free throw. It's up. Short this time. Ligon is there, though, to get the rebound. He'll try a hook shot. No good. Fall up underneath is good by Scott of Kokomo. Ligon missed his shot, but Scott was there to tap it in, and it's 83-55. There's a long shot by Farrell. It's good. Farrell pumped one in from 25 feet on the diagonal. 83-57. Kokomo over Logansport with 1 minute 40 seconds remaining. Underneath it goes to Burke. Hits his foot, goes out of bounds. Awarded to Logansport. All right, Logansport has it. Onto the attack. Dan Farrell, shot inside the free throw line. No good. He takes another shot. It's good. Farrell banks one in, and it's 83-59. Kokomo leads. Foul's been called and on Logansport at the present time. 83-59. Kokomo leading. The foul was on Dan Farrell of Logansport. Isert has two free throws. He hits his first one. It's a one-on-one situation. And with a minute 25 seconds remaining, it's Kokomo 84, Logansport 59. The second shot by Isert is good. And now makes it 85-59, Kokomo over Logansport. Newton has it in the offensive court, still drives all the way under, lays it up. Foul, and a foul on Foster of Kokomo. It's Mike Newton on the free throw. There's the first one. It's up. It's good. 85-60. Referees clear the lane, hand the ball back to Mike Newton. There's his second free throw. Short this time. They fight for it, and Foster clears for the Wildcats. Up Kokomo. Kokomo on the attack now. Still going is Buschlag. A shot underneath. by Burt is good by Kokomo, and it's 87-60. Kokomo by 27 points with 1 minute remaining in the fourth period. All right, Newton has it back to free throw lane. Underneath it goes to Farrell. His shot is good. Farrell banks it in for Logan Sports. 87-62. The Wildcats will feed inbounds. They do so to Taylor, to Foster off on the far side now. To Bushlag. Bushlag almost drops it. Finds an open man underneath in the person of Isert. His shot was no good and picked up by Farrell of Logansport. Logansport on the attack. Farrell shot 20 feet out, in and out this time. Farrell controls his own rebound, however. Gets around to Foster. A shot off on the far side. Was no good. And a foul's been called on Kokomo. All right, Dick Shook at the free throw line. He has two shots coming. There's his first free throw. It's good. 87-63. It's the score with 27 seconds remaining. There's the second shot by Shook, and it's also good. He hit two in a row from the charity lane. 87-64 now with 25 seconds remaining. Kokomo has it in the backcourt. Bushlag has a hard time getting it up in the offensive court. Off on the far side, it goes to Burt. Whistle underneath, and a foul called on Logansport. Foul was on Vance. Here's Isert at the free throw line. His shot was no good, and Logansport controls. Shook clears nicely for the Logansport Braves. A shot by Vance underneath is good. And it's 87-66. Kokomo leading. Underneath it goes to Bushlag. He drives under. His shot was no good. They fight for it, and finally cleared by Kokomo. A shot by Foster is no good. There's the end of the ball game. 87-66 is the final score. Kokomo winning over the Logansport Braves.